Good morning. Welcome to Church of the Ascension. My name is Cynthia Roys, and thank you for celebrating with us on this fifth Sunday of Easter. The Mass intention for this liturgy is for the deceased, Kathleen Sharon. Today's Mass is being streamed live. We are united today both in person and with our online family. We ask those present with us to kindly silence your cell phones. Bishop Nestout has requested the diocese to recite a special prayer to the Holy Spirit for the guidance in making efforts to re-engage the faithful who have been away because of the pandemic. This prayer will be read later during Mass today. YOA Golf Classic is May 21st. To register as a golfer, sponsor, or donor, visit the church website events link. Town hall meetings are still being offered this week to present information about Ascension's Growing Our Future campaign to support the new parish office and help lay a financial foundation for the future. Please see the website to register or call the business office. The dates are Tuesday, May 4th, and Thursday, May 6th, all at 7 p.m. in the sanctuary. Please register for the evening that best fits your schedule. Please rise.
Let us build a house where love can dwell and all can safely live. A place where saints and children tell how hearts learn to forgive. Built of hopes and dreams and visions, rock of faith and vault of grace. Here the love of Christ shall end divisions. All are welcome, all are welcome, all are welcome in this place. Let us build a house where prophets speak and words are strong and true. Where all God's children dare to seek, to dream God's reign anew. Here the cross shall stand as witness and as symbol of God's grace. Here as one we claim the faith of Jesus. All are welcome, all are welcome, all are welcome.
Good morning.
Good morning, Father.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
We have just finished this song, which reminds us that all of us, we are welcome. We are welcome to this wonderful community to celebrate, to proclaim the good news, and to serve the local community. Today in the Gospel, we hear Jesus identifies himself as a true vine, and we are his branches. And he wants us to stay connected in his presence, in his life, because the branches cannot survive if they separate themselves with the vine. Let us continue to see the presence of Christ in our lives, to continue to enjoy his love and his mercy in coming together as God's family. Let us acknowledge our sins and ask for God's love and mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are mighty God and Prince of Peace. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are Son of God and Son of Mary. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are Word made flesh and splendor of the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us and forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life.
Glory, glory to God in the highest. Glory, glory to God in the highest. And on earth, peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father. Glory, glory to God in the highest. Glory, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. Glory, glory to God in the highest. Glory, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Glory, glory to God in the highest. Glory, glory to God in the highest. And on earth, peace to people of goodwill. Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, constantly accomplish the Paschal mystery within us, that those you were pleased to make new in holy baptism may, under your protective care, bear much fruit and come to the joys of life eternal. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. When Saul arrived in Jerusalem, he tried to join the disciples, but they were all afraid of him, not believing he was a disciple. Then Barnabas took charge of him and brought him to the apostles, and he reported to them how he had seen the Lord, and that he had spoken to him, and how in Damascus he had spoken out boldly in the name of Jesus. He moved about freely with them in Jerusalem and spoke out boldly in the name of the Lord. He also spoke and debated with the Hellenists, but they tried to kill him. And when the brothers learned of this, they took him down to Caesarea and sent him on his way to Tarsus. The church throughout all Judea, Galilee, and Samaria was at peace. It was being built up and walked in the fear of the Lord, and with the consolation of the Holy Spirit, it grew in numbers. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
will praise you, Lord, in the presence of your people. I will praise you, Lord, in the presence of your people.
I will fulfill my vows before those who fear the Lord. They who seek the Lord, may your hearts live forever.
I will praise you, Lord, in the presence of your people. I will praise you, Lord, in the presence of your people.
All the ends of the earth shall remember and turn to the Lord. All the families of the nations shall bow down before him.
I will praise you, Lord, in the presence of your people. I will praise you, Lord, in the presence of your people.
To him alone shall bow down all who sleep. Before him shall bend all who go down into the dust.
I will praise you, Lord, in the presence of your people. I will praise you, Lord, in the presence of your people.
A reading from the first letter of St. John. Children, let us love not in word or speech, but in deed and truth. Now this is how we shall know that we belong to the truth and reassure our hearts before him in whatever our hearts condemn. For God is greater than our hearts and knows everything. Beloved, if our hearts do not condemn us, we have confidence in God and receive from him whatever we ask, because we keep his commandments and do what pleases him. And his commandment is this: we should believe in the name of his Son, Jesus Christ, and love one another as he commanded us. Those who keep his commandments remain in him and he in them. And the way we know that he remains in us is from the Spirit he gave us. The word of the Lord.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Remain in me, says the Lord. Remain in me, and you will bear much fruit. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to his disciples, "I am the true vine, and my Father is the vine grower. He takes away every branch in me that does not bear fruit, and every one that does, he prunes so that it bears more fruit. You are already pruned because of the word that I spoke to you. Remain in me as I remain in you. Just as a branch cannot bear fruit on its own unless it remains on the vine, neither can you unless you remain in me. I am the vine, you are the branches. Whoever remains in me and I in him will bear much fruit, because without me you can do nothing. Anyone who does not remain in me will be thrown out like a branch and wither. People will gather them and throw them into a fire, and they will be burned. If you remain in me and my words remain in you, ask for whatever you want, and it will be done for you. By this, my Father is glorified, that you bear much fruit and become my disciples. The Gospel of the Lord. As you just heard, today's gospel is the parable of the vine and the branches. God is the vine grower. Jesus is the vine. He is the connection between our Creator and His creation. The vine grower wants a fruitful harvest. To that end, branches are nourished through the vine. Non-productive branches are removed and thrown away. Productive branches are trimmed so that they may be more fruitful. We are the branches. Through Jesus, we are nourished with gifts and graces that allow us to grow spiritually and to be more fruitful as disciples of Jesus Christ. So, why aren't our branches filled with disciples? In our being, we have both human and divine elements present, body and soul. On one hand, we dwell in a world which is experienced through our human senses. That's the human or fleshy part, the body. On the other hand, through faith, we learn we also are in the kingdom of heaven. That is the divine or the spiritual element, the soul. Scripture tells us that the flesh has desires against the spirit and the spirit against the flesh. These are opposed to each other so that you may not have what you want. No wonder I get confused. About the kingdom of God, Scripture tells us many things. It is at hand. The mystery of it has been granted to us. One cannot enter it without being born of water and a spirit. And anyone who does not accept it like child, like faith, will not enter it. I enjoy watching a TV series called The Chosen. In one of the episodes, the relationship between Jesus and children is developed. At his campground outside of town, Jesus meets a young boy and girl who spend a pleasant day with Jesus. Because of this, they bring some friends with them on subsequent days. The children are happily helping Jesus as he works his carpentry tasks. This all happens against the background of an ongoing dialogue wherein Jesus is getting to know the kids and they are getting to know him. Jesus is patiently answering their curiosity questions. His replies are simple and straightforward, but they also teach about God and faith. This exchange with the children occurs before Jesus begins his public ministry. Now, fast forward. And Jesus has begun his public ministry. He is in town, and the people are swarming to him for healing and to hear him teach. In order to avoid the crush of the crowd and to get a better view of Jesus, some of the adults scurry to the roof of the building across the home where Jesus is teaching. There, they find two of the children sitting on the edge of the roof. The kids are simply and happily listening to their friend Jesus of Nazareth. It is clear to the adults that these two know Jesus. Jesus took on human form and came into our world to teach us about the Father and about love. He brought spiritual wisdom into human existence so that we might be able to enter into eternal life when our worldly journey is complete. Unfortunately, Satan and his minions are also present in the world, and they are attempting to lead us astray. That was true in the times of Jesus, and it is true today. The world humanity perceives through our senses frequently fails to recognize or accept his spiritual wisdom, that which was provided from God to nourish our being. The chosen episode I described is a healthy relationship between Jesus and the children. It shows that a healthy relationship has been established. They are too young to be affected by the mental pollution of worldly origin. The hearts and minds were unencumbered by worldly issues, and they were nourished. Their faith grew. The relationship with the person of Jesus flourished. Maybe this is an oversimplification, but it seems to me that that may be how a personal relationship between Jesus and each one of us occurs. In researching this gospel, I came across two reflections that suggested this passage was about spiritual development. In one case, the point was made that in spiritual development, desire and effort are both required. If desire is missing, the biological world will continue to go on, but the spiritual life recedes. In this sense, a spiritual death is occurring, one that prevents spiritual growth from reaching its full potential. If desire or effort are missing, the dying process is underway. The vine grower knows this. Those that are dead branches are then trimmed and thrown away. But if people are trying, and the operative word is trying, then pruning is opportune, and items that hinder growth are removed. Spiritual development advances, and there is always the possibility of more and better fruit. This can be painful. We are admonished to always give thanks, but in the pain of the moment, that may not be possible. Human emotion can prevent recognition of the good that can and does emerge. I promise you, if you look back after pruning, you will realize that it was for your own good and that you are in a much better place for having gone through it. In the second case, spiritual progress comes through Jesus. Our job is to say yes, to surrender. When we remain in Christ, we acknowledge that God is the source of all that is good, including the good that he calls me to do. So often we struggle and make no progress, then frustration sets in and we wonder why. The answer is simple. What is it that I'm afraid to lose? What worldly influence is holding on to me so tightly that I don't say yes to God? What the Lord offers is so much better than anything that I have. So let it go. What is it that I'm afraid of? Let go of that too. In the image of the vine and the branches, we see clearly that our life is from the Lord. Everything that is good comes from him. If we surrender and bear fruit, the Father will work in us to produce more. It's all about how we respond to the gifts and graces provided by the Creator. Do we use them wisely? Do we recognize in our lives? Are we willing to be the eyes, ears, mouth, hands, and feet of the Lord? Are we being fruitful disciples of the Lord Jesus Christ? Amen.
Please stand and profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended to heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. We have confidence in our merciful God, who gives us whatever we ask.
For the Church, under the guidance of Pope Francis, as he continues to make Jesus known to the world through words of hope and works of love, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For world leaders, that they may heed the words of the gospel to cooperate with one another, as in an effort to seek peace and prosperity branches for all, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we, as the children of God, may express our love in the concrete actions by visiting the sick, feeding the hungry, and protecting the unborn, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For your comfort and healing to all who carry the cross of pain and suffering, especially Ed Agbuya, those who have been affected by COVID, those chronically ill listed in our bulletin, and those whose names we mention aloud now. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all those who have died, especially Kyle Midkiff, grandson of Sandra Midkiff, Kenneth Reed, son of Betty Reed, and in memory of Joanne Gahan, Kathleen Sharon, and Nita Ford, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And now our special prayer to the Holy Spirit. Come, Holy Spirit, and guide us throughout the Diocese of Richmond as we embark on our third century in your service. We humbly ask you to strengthen our trust in you and our eagerness to share the gospel message with others. Enkindle in us a keen desire to grow in our relationship with you and to encounter you in your sacraments. Through the intercession of Mary, star of the new evangelization, and St. Vincent de Paul, may we experience a new Pentecost and a profound renewal of faith in our diocese, our parishes, our families, and our hearts.
Let us pray. All-knowing God, we are the fruit of your Son's vine. We ask that you listen to our prayers in the name of your Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated. Due to COVID protocol, donation baskets are located by the doors as you exit the sanctuary. Thank you for your continued support.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. O God, who by the wonderful exchange effected in this sacrifice have made us partakers of the one supreme Godhead, grant, we pray, that as we have come to know your truth, we may make it ours by a worthy way of life, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
And lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is true, right and just, to our duty and our salvation at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but at this time above all to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ, our Passover, has been sacrificed. He never ceases to offer himself for us, but defends us and ever pleads our cause before you. He is the sacrificial victim who dies no more, the lamb once slain who lives forever. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land and every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with angelic host sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they are acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightfully gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread and, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread and gave it to disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with the Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, and Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, and bury our bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Remember your servant, Catherine Sharon, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she who was united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth he will raise up in the flesh those who have died and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters too, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages and praise you without end, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen, 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 amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from evil, evil. Gracious, grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and gracious grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit. Let us share with each other a sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world.
world. Have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
One bread, one body, one cup, one call, one faith, one spirit, present in us all. One prayer, one blessing, one hope, one peace. One church, one people, one love released. Is not this bread we share the body of our Lord? Is not this wine we drink the blood of Christ outpoured? One bread, one body, one cup, one call, one faith, one spirit, present in us all. One prayer, one blessing, one hope, one peace, one church, one people, one love release. I am the bread of life, eat and you shall live. Share this meal, my strength I'll always give. One bread, one body, one cup, one call, one faith, one spirit, present in us all. One hope, one peace, one church, one people, one love released. I am the living bread as manna from the sky. This bread I give to you that you may never die. One bread, one body,
one cup, one cup. One faith, one spirit, present in us all. One prayer, one blessing, one hope, one peace. One church, one people, one love released.
All the colors of the rainbow, all the voices of the wind, every dream that reaches out, that reaches out to find when love begins. Every word of every star in every sky, corner of creation lives to testify.
For as long as I shall live, I will testify to love.
I'll be a witness in the silences when words are not enough.
With every breath I take,
I will give thanks to God above. For as long as I shall live, I will testify to love. From the mountains to the valleys, from the rivers to the sea, every hand that reaches out, every hand that reaches out to offer peace, every simple of mercy, every step to kingdom come, and the hope in every heart will speak what love has done.
For as long as I shall live, I will testify to love.
I'll be the witness in the silences when words are not enough.
With every breath I take,
I will give thanks to God above.
For as long as I shall live, I will testify to love. For as long as I shall live, I will testify to love.
I'll be a witness in the silences when words are not enough.
With every breath I take,
I will give thanks to God above.
For as long as I shall live, I will testify to love.
I am the true vine, and you are the branches, says the Lord. Whoever remains in me, and I in him, bears fruit in plenty. Alleluia. Let us pray. Graciously be present to your people, we pray, O Lord, and lead those you have imbued with heavenly mysteries to pass from former ways to newness of life. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated. If this is your first time back at Mass since the coronavirus descended on us, please raise your hand. Yes, sir, welcome back. You were missed. We also have a tradition here of welcoming visitors and newcomers, and if you are one of those, I would ask you to stand, tell us your name and where you are from. Do we have any visitors or newcomers? Yes, sir. Your name and where you're from, please. Charlottesville, Virginia. Welcome. Yes, ma'am. From Missouri. Welcome. Do we have any others? Okay, please keep in mind the coronavirus safety things that we have to observe as you exit, and then please stand for the final blessing.
I want to remind you that on Wednesday, after the Mass at 9:15, which will be around 9:45, we invite those who are unable to join us either on Tuesday or Thursday for that Growing Our Future meeting. Some of you maybe might not be able to drive in the evening, but we want to invite you to come after 9:15 Mass, and then you can join with us. So we want to give everyone the time to come, the possibility to come and join with us for the discussion of our parish and for the well-being of our parish. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your lives. Thanks be to God.
And as a gentle reminder, your song sheet is a one-time use. So on your way out, if you could please place it in the blue recycle can by the outer door. Thank you.
Men of faith, rise up and sing of the great and glorious King. You are strong when you feel weak, in your brokenness complete.
Shout to the north and the south, sing to the east and the west. Jesus is Savior to all, Lord of heaven and earth.
We will shout to the north and the south, sing to the east and the west. Jesus is Savior to all, Lord of heaven and earth.
Rise up, women of the truth, stand and sing to broken hearts. Who can know the healing power of our awesome King of love?
Shout to the north and the south, sing to the east and the west. Jesus is Savior to all, Lord of heaven and earth. We will shout to the north and the south, sing to the east and the west. Jesus is Savior to all, Lord of heaven and earth.
Thank you, everyone.